I will show you how to install Stable Diffusion, even if you have never used it before. So put on your seatbelts if you have them, and let's get it started. So we first need to download Python 3.10.6. Scroll down to the downloads. I will then download Python. You want to make sure that Python 3.10 to pod is checked over here. This is a really important step. Then select on install now, and it will then install Python. When the setup is done, then you can close the installer. So after that, we need to download Git. So get the standalone installer. You want to run the Git installer you downloaded. Then click on next on each one of these prompts. Then it will install Git. Once the Git installation is complete, click on finish. So go on your file browser. So I'm going to go on my C drive. I am going to create a folder. I will name it Stable Diffusion Automatic 1111. But you can name it whatever you want. I am going to then click on it. So go in the navigation box on the file browser and then delete everything on it so it's empty. Then you want to type cmd. It will then bring the command prompt. So go on your web browser, go on Stable Diffusion Automatic 1111 GitHub page. Then you want to copy the line over here where it says git clone. Go back on the command prompt and click on it. And then press control V, then press on enter. It will get all of these files which are for Automatic 1111. So scroll down until you find the WebUI bat or batch file. You want to right click on it and then go on edit on notepad. So go on the top and press on enter. Then this will leave an empty line on the top. You then want to type git pull. This is going to allow Stable Diffusion to stay up to date. So then you want to go on the section where there's a command line list. So if you have 4 GB of video RAM or less, then type med VRAM. And if you have 2 GB or less, then type low VRAM. This will help optimize your Stable Diffusion. If you want Stable Diffusion to work faster, then I recommend you type here Xformers. If you want the dark theme, then you can type theme dark. After that, go on file and then click on save and then close out of the notepad. So you want to then launch WebUI bat file. It will then start downloading all the assets that Stable Diffusion will need to run. So let it do its thing, as it might take some time getting it all downloaded. Once it's all done, it will then bring the web UI of the Stable Diffusion Automatic 1111. If it doesn't automatically bring you to the Automatic 1111 page, then you can go back on the command prompt. Then you can select over the URL, control C to copy, and then go back on your web browser and then paste it on it. And then go on it, it then should bring you to the web UI of Stable Diffusion. So the Stable Diffusion checkpoints will load up, which comes with the base model. The prompt box here will allow us to generate image based on what it's written on the prompt. So I will write down a cat wearing a hat and then click on generate. As you can see, we just got a picture generated by Stable Diffusion with a cat wearing a hat. So if you want to generate again, it will then give you another type of image of a cat wearing a hat. If you go down here to adjust the batch count to something like 5, we can then produce 5 images in one go instead of one. So click on generate, it will then produce 5 images of a cat wearing a hat. So go to Civit AI. Over here, you can get custom made models. So just make sure you pick a checkpoint that you like. And then once you decided on which one to download, then click on download. Once it's fully downloaded, you want to then go to where it was downloaded. Then you just want to right click on the model you just downloaded and then press on copy. You then want to go to where you installed Stable Diffusion. It is on our C drive where the Stable Diffusion folder is. So once you are on the main folder, you want to then go on models and then go on Stable Diffusion folder and then right click and paste the file here. So you want to go back on your Stable Diffusion main folder, then run WebUI user bat. So once you get on the WebUI, it should be able to load up your Stable Diffusion model. So we will select the custom model that we downloaded, then write on the prompt box cat wearing a hat and click on generate. As you can see, it came out in a different style. So this is how to install Stable Diffusion on Windows using automatic 1111. Anyways, check out my other videos and yogamo guys, and have a yogamalicious day.